The central challenge facing Israel is how to ensure its long-term existence as a Jewish democratic state. This challenge has three dimensions. The first is to reach peace with our neighbors based on a two-state solution. The second is to address the internal strife that has riven one people into four tribes, the ones that our president mentioned yesterday. And the third is to define a new and enlightened Zionist identity that will endow us with both the spirit and the ethos of thriving open democracy together with an open, robust, and meaningful Judaism. Our first act should be to find a common language. When I say common, I mean both literally and figuratively. We have a rare and sacred national treasure, the Hebrew language, Ha'ivrit, the language of the Bible and the State of Israel. In order for us to be able to speak to one another and listen to one another and to debate, discuss, and delight one another, we must return to our national heritage and treasure. We must enable every young Jewish person in the world to learn Hebrew. Hence, I hereby call upon the State of Israel to honor its commitment and pledge to take care of the Jewish people in the diaspora by allocating substantial share of a budget towards teaching Hebrew all over the world. From here on, it will be every young Jew's birthright, wherever he or she may live, not only to visit this historical homeland, but to learn the language of the Jewish people. Hebrew can be a common denominator of all Jews from all streams of Judaism and of affiliated and non-affiliated Jews. Our beautiful language can serve as a tool for unity. We at the Jewish Agency, for example, have succeeded in incredible ulpans on the website by distance learning in the former Soviet Union. Some have suggested a Jewish Peace Corps that will allow young Jews of the diaspora alongside young Israelis to carry out work of tikkun olam in third world countries. Others have suggested inviting tens of thousands of young Jews from the diaspora to take part in this the exciting enterprise of the startup nation. And still others have suggested using innovative technology and social networks to connect us all by one big global Jewish community. We will review all these ideas and in due course decide upon them together with you.